Hey guys, so today I created this soft, matte, kind of pinky, purpley look, and I used the Natasha Denona Safari palette for Flashback Friday. I believe this palette's on sale for like half off, so I thought it'd be a good time to dig it up and play with it again. And before we get started with this makeup look, this video is sponsored by Scentbird. I've been working with Scentbird for a while now, and I really like their monthly fragrance subscription service. So each month you get to choose a new designer fragrance for only $15. So this is the size of the fragrance you get. It has about 130 sprays in it, which is a lot more than the tiny little samples you get from like Sephora or Ulta. So you can kind of see the size comparison there. This one is much bigger. So Scentbird also carries products from other categories like makeup, skincare, bath and body, even candles. But I'm going to show you the three fragrances that I picked out from Scentbird. So one cool thing about Scentbird is that you can try out new brands of fragrances without spending like $60+, right? So one fragrance brand that I've learned to love from Scentbird is called Confessions of a Rebel. So I got the fragrance Bitch Please. So the notes in Bitch Please are blackcurrant, jasmine, sandalwood, and skin musk. I personally really like musky perfumes, and I love sandalwood too, so this one is just like delicious. I'm gonna show you how these little vials work. So it comes in this little travel friendly container, and you just twist it up, your fragrance little pops out there so you can spray it. Poof. And then if you want to check what fragrance you have in there, you just pull out the vial and it says right there what fragrance you have. Oh my gosh, it smells so good from spraying it. Oh, I love sandalwood. And then you just pop it back in, twist down, good to go. So the next fragrance I got is the Catherine Maladrino Dream. So this fragrance is like a fruity, floral, and musk. It's so good. The notes are apple, rhubarb, muguet, peony, and sheer musk. I personally really like apple in my fragrances, and it stays pretty well on me. This is the one I'm wearing today, and I love it. It's a very like sophisticated fragrance too, for being like a fruity floral. You know? And then the last fragrance I got is the Christian Siriano Ulla Rouge. So again, this one is like a fruity floral musk. You can kind of sense what I like here. So the notes in this one are saffron flower, ruby grapefruit, praline, white star jasmine, and amber wood. And this one came in a cute little blue vial. How cute is this color? So this one's kind of in the same family as the Dream one, but this one's like a little brighter, I feel like. So those are the three fragrances that I got from Scentbird. So if you want to check out Scentbird and save some money on some new fragrances, I'm gonna leave a link and a coupon code down below for you in the description box for 30% off your first month. Now let's get into this makeup look. So I'm starting this video with my base makeup on. I'm excited to dig into this palette. I haven't used this palette in so long, but I just love all the colors in here and all the beautiful matte shades. I'm kind of feeling something soft pinky purple, so I'll probably stick to the bottom row there. And if you didn't see my video from Monday where I posted I broke my arm, my left arm is still healing, so I can't use my left hand to do my makeup yet. I just don't have that range of motion yet. So I will be using my right hand today, which is my non-dominant hand. I can do makeup okay with it, but it does take a lot longer and kind of more blending than usual, but we'll get through it. I can't really point to the shadows because I can only use one hand, but I'm going to show you. So I'm going to take that Malia shade in the top left corner. I'm taking that on a Sigma E35, and I'm going to kind of blend this into my crease. My blending motions are so like not fluid when I use my right hand. But I thought it would be a good time to use this palette because it's half off now. It's like $60-something instead of $129 or whatever. So if you've been wanting to try Natasha Denona shadows, this is a perfect time since it's on sale. So this is just giving me like the softest little wash of pink in my crease. Okay, now I'm gonna take a lid brush. This is a Sigma E54. I'm gonna take that shade Lotus in the bottom left-hand corner. I'm gonna pack that all over my lid. All right, so I have that packed on. Now I'm gonna go back to my E35, my fluffy brush, and just blend in the crease to help blend out some of these harsh edges of this pink shade. That looks pretty. Now I'm gonna take a little bit more Lotus and just pack it on my lid again. But I'm kind of staying closer to like my lash line area. Now I'm gonna take more Lotus on the tip of my E54 and I'm gonna run that along my lower lash line. And then taking more Malia on my E35 and just blending. Okay, I like how this looks. It's just like a little wash of pink all around the eyes. I think I wanna add just a little bit of depth. I'm gonna take that middle purple shade on the bottom row. I don't know how you say that, Maasai? Maasai, I think. And again, taking some of that on my E54. And I think I just wanna add a little bit on my outer corner here, just to add a little bit of depth. And a little on the lower lash line too, just right out here. And then if you need to blend a little bit, of course you can. I'm gonna blend right here. So I'm kind of using like the tip of this brush for my lower lash line, and then on my lid, I use like the flat side of it. It's a good brush. You can kind of just keep going back and forth till it's as dark as you want it to be. You can even go darker and add some voodoo if you want to, but I think I'm pretty happy with this. My blending is not perfect, but again, I'm using my non-dominant hand. It's fine. All right, I'm just gonna finish this off with a little bit of a highlighter. There's no like shimmery light shade in the palette, so I'm gonna use this CoverGirl one that I like. And I'm using a Sigma L04. Okay, and then I think I'm just gonna do mascara today. I'm just not in the mood to put on liner or lashes, so I'm gonna use the Fenty Beauty one. I've really been liking this one a lot. I feel like I'm missing something on the eyes, but I don't want to do eyeliner. Think I'm just gonna leave it as it is because this was a super easy matte look to do. I used what, like 3 shades? I'm gonna finish off with my new dream perfume that I have in this red casing. Oh, I freaking love the apple in this. It's so good. So I hope you guys enjoyed this very easy look using the Natasha Denona Safari palette. And don't forget, if you want to check out Scentbird, I'm going to leave a link down below for you where you can get 30% off your first month. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.